Hello and welcome to Low Budget Gaming, and welcome to this updated guide on how to get 60 FPS and like better performance, no lag on PUBG Mobile on PC using the Tencent Gaming Buddy. Now, in the previous video that I made, I had showed you how to do that using a tool. This time we are not going to use anything else. We're just using the gaming app and the game itself. There are two main sets of settings that we need to look into to try to get the maximum performance. So first, obviously, you need to install the game. Using the link below, you can download the Buddy app and install PUBG. Now, what I've noticed is the updates don't seem to work when you have it already installed. So what I try to do is, like, every week or so, every couple of weeks, I uninstall the whole thing and reinstall it again. So I get the updates that way. They don't seem to update properly from within the game itself. So the first set of settings is obviously in the Buddy app. So we click on the three lines, go into settings, go into engine, and these are the settings that I'm using. Now I have a Ryzen 5 1600, which is a 6-core processor, but I've selected 8 cores, and obviously 1080p, 480 here. I have 16 GB RAM, so I've selected 4, that's the maximum it'll go, and anti-aliasing, I've gone for ultimate. Over here in the rendering, this will depend on what you have. So I've gone with a DirectX Plus. I've been trying this out and I haven't really seen much of a difference. I had used DirectX as well and similar sort of performance. But this is the one that is important: prioritize dedicated GPU. Now, if you end up getting a white screen or something, that's probably because of DirectX. So maybe select OpenGL or OpenGL Plus, or maybe the smart mode itself. So these are what you need. In the game settings, click on the smooth settings, because we are trying to get smoother performance and we are not worried about graphics that much. Obviously, this is the mobile port, so graphics don't really matter that much anyway. So save this, and then we'll open the game and I'll talk through the settings inside the game itself. Well, let's select the show FPS so I can show you how it looks. As you can see, the game is starting and we are getting that 60-57 FPS. But when we go into the main menu, the lobby area, we sometimes see that it drops back to 30. Now, this seems to be either a bug or if it's a setting thing. Now, you can see this has gone back to 30. So we'll fix that before we start playing. We go into the settings and go into the graphics. So these are the graphics settings and I'll talk you through them. So select the smooth settings so that it becomes smoother as the gameplay. Otherwise, you can go for a higher quality look, but the game becomes a bit choppy. So we need performance, so we are going for smooth. And frame rate, we want extreme. So target extreme to get the maximum FPS. So lower numbers mean they'll target lower. This is meant for the mobile phone anyway, so ignore this part, just go for the extreme if you are on PC. Style, this doesn't matter, but this just depends on how you like the game to look. I've gone with colorful, so it saturates the game a bit. You can see things better. Now, this one, select enable, and this is the most important option here: auto adjust graphics. Now, what this does is, if the FPS fluctuates too much, it locks it down to 30. So you want this to be disabled. Now, notice up here is stuck at 2930. So what you can do is you can just click enable and select OK, and then go back to disable. Just by drawing that again, you can see it's gone up to 5860. Now, I've played the few games, I've played for about 2-3 hours using these settings, and I'm getting comfortably around 55 to 60 FPS most of the time. Occasionally, it still dips to like 30 something occasionally, but like for 1 or 2 frames. But otherwise, it stays at around 55-60 all the time. So, try these out. These are the settings that I've found best to work with my system. And if you have a dedicated GPU with at least 8 GB RAM separate on the PC with 4 cores, you should get similar performance. But of course, they are constantly updating this because this is obviously in beta, so expect the performance to improve. And what I would recommend once again is uninstall the whole thing and reinstall it again every 2-3 weeks or something to get like the best updates, because I don't see where we can update this. And I've tried updating it at the start, but some of the settings they only appear when I uninstall and reinstall the game, so keep that in mind as well. And hopefully, yeah, this works and this gives you good frame rates. And let me know what you think. We don't need the graphics tool anymore. This should work fine. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.